Good morning, everybody. Now let us come to the conclusion of this chapter and see what all we have studied in this chapter. So in the beginning, we studied who are tribal people. So we studied that tribal people are those people who were living in forested areas or in the hills or in the places which were difficult to reach, and all of them were related to kinship bonds, and there was no high or low system in them. They were not divided into unequal castes like the caste-based societies. So they did not follow the Brahmanical religion or the religion which was followed by the caste-based society. These then we studied about the different tribes which inhabited different parts of India. We have studied the tribes which lived in Punjab, Multan, Sindh, Central India, then in South India, Gujarat. So many, many tribes we studied. Then we studied that many of them, their occupation was either shifting cultivation, or some of them did settled cultivation. Some of them were herders, hunters, gatherers. Some of them were nomadic pastoralists. So out of that, we studied about one group of nomadic pastoralists, that is the Banjaras. So Banjaras lived during the medieval period, and their mention is there in the Akbarnama also. Then it is mentioned in Alauddin Khalji's accounts also, he used the Banjaras to transport the grains. Then Jahangir also has mentioned about this Banjaras. Then we studied that when the tribal societies had to intermingle with the caste-based societies, so changes occurred in both caste-based societies and the tribal societies. So many changes we studied, change in the religion, change in the administrative system. Slowly, the religion of the caste-based system came in the tribal society also. Then we studied about two important kingdoms, tribal kingdoms, that is Gond kingdom and Ahom kingdom. So Gonds used to live in the Gondwana land area, and the major change which occurred was the unequal, they divided themselves into unequal societies, but they were great political and administrative powers. Even the Ahoms were great administrative and political powers, and both of them had to fight with the Mughals. So they also fought with the big empires. But they maintained their identity for a long time. So apart from all this what we have studied till now, there was one more nomadic pastoralist community which was not in India, but which was one of the famous pastoralist community, and that was the Mongols. So the Mongols were the best known pastoral and hunter-gatherer tribes, and they inhabited the grasslands of Central Asia. We call the grasslands of Central Asia steppes, and they also occupied the forested areas in the northern parts. And by 1206, Genghis Khan or Chinggis Khan, he united the Mongol tribes and the Turkish tribes, and they were all converted into a powerful military force. And this Chinggis Khan attacked India also. His successors also created vast empires, and they created their empires in some parts of Russia, some parts of Eastern Europe, some parts of China, West Asia. They had a well-organized military and the administrative system. And these Mongols, whom we call as Mughals, they later occupied India also. So this is all about the chapter, Tribes, Nomads and Settled Communities. Please go through the chapter, go through all the figures and the new words given, go through the video and learn the question answer.